What's the most important city in Canada? That's easy. It's the one that you love. Probably your home today, or maybe your hometown where you grew up. NDP leader Thomas Mulcair has a different answer that he gave at Olivia Chow's campaign office. Take a look.
Toronto is Canada's most important city. Only when Toronto is strong is Canada strong.
Well, that's not quite true. I will concede that Toronto is Canada's largest city, that it is Canada's banking headquarters and media headquarters, and most corporate offices are here too. But the geographical center of gravity has moved west to Calgary and Vancouver and Fort McMurray. I'm not going to say those are more important cities than Toronto. Mulcair's comments were weird, not because he said Toronto was more important than Calgary or Vancouver. It's that he said any city was more important than any other city. That's like a mom saying she loves one child more than another child, that one child is more important than another. The rebuttal isn't, no, the other child is more important. The rebuttal is, all children are important and your job is to love them all. Of course, what Thomas Mulcair really meant to say is that Toronto is politically the most important to him. If he's going to win the next election, he needs to hold seats in Quebec, but he needs to pick up seats in Toronto. He's hoping Olivia Chow helps do that for him, which is funny. I mean, she used to be an NDP member of parliament from downtown Toronto, but then she quit last year to run for the mayor of Toronto. Now, that was that caused an expensive by-election federally, but hey, Toronto is more important, right? Anyways, a Liberal named Adam Vaughan won that by-election, and Chow came in a disastrous third place in the mayor's race at just 23% of the vote. So now, barely a year later, she wants to run for her old seat in parliament again. At what point does someone say to a career politician, how about getting a real job? But one last word about Mulcair saying Toronto is the most important. Look at what else he said. Take a listen.
Canada thrives when Toronto thrives, and Olivia has always been an outstanding advocate for Toronto.
Now, that's just not true. Toronto can be going gangbusters, but Atlantic Canada can be in an economic malaise. That's actually been true for many of the past decades. Toronto can be doing fine while Alberta is in a recession and is starting to happen now. It's not true that all of Canada thrives when Toronto thrives. And from the point of view of a Westerner, part of the reason Toronto does thrive is because the energy-producing provinces, the have provinces of BC, Alberta, and Saskatchewan, are subsidizing the have-not province of Ontario. Every dollar of federal money that's spent in Toronto, whether it's on bloated Pan Am Games or the bloated transit system or whatever, is subsidized by other provinces. And I know that sounds nutty. It never used to be that way, but under Kathleen Wynne's Liberals, Ontario has become a have-not province. It's become the largest debtor in the world that's not an independent country, which in itself drags the rest of the country down. Now, I live in Toronto, and then there are many nice things about Toronto. It's my home, so it's important to me. I will never say that Toronto is not important. It also has important traffic jams, and you can pay $40 a day for an important parking spot downtown, and you pay very important taxes for very important bureaucrats, don't I know it. But Thomas Mulcair is just plain wrong when he says Canada automatically thrives when Toronto thrives. There's more to Canada than what you can see from the top of the CN Tower or from the NDP's campaign offices. For the Rebel.media, I'm Ezra Levance.